Okay, the song title is One of the Millions. If you won $1 million or you got $1 million, what would you do right now? Right now. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you're having a lovely day. My name is Justin, and today we are, of course, listening to XTC with their song One in the Millions off of their album Oranges and Lemons, which was released in 1989. Actually, really quick, I'll be right back. I want to show you something. Hold on. So my wife has taken up the new hobby of making like clay earrings and stuff. And one of the ones that she's practicing and working on right now are lemon earrings. Hold on, I'm going to show you. She said they're not done yet, but let me show you kind of like a little what she's doing. Anyways, what was I talking about before? If you had $1 million, what would you do? Right now, what would I do? Honestly, I don't know if I could. I would try this YouTube thing. Maybe try and, I don't know if I could quit my job, but maybe look for something part-time or something and be able to like focus more on the channel. That might give me a little more time. I guess I'd buy a house too. Definitely. I've always wanted a house. That'd be nice. otherwise maybe take a small vacation and put the rest in savings. I don't know. Kind of boring, I guess. Join me on Twitter in the comments below. Hope you're having a beautiful day. And hope that lottery ticket you scratched off today or yesterday maybe reaps you a reward or two. Let's do it. This is One of the Millions by XTC.
Schemes come to an humiliating end, so I won't.
You know what's funny? In me listening to this album, and perhaps this is because this album is my first overall exposure to XTC, even though, of course, we've done a few songs otherwise here and there. But I know that apparently this album isn't like one of their most highly ranked ones. Like, I always see English Settlement, Skylarking, Nonsuch even, but I never see this one kind of like ranked up there. But I mean, maybe that just shows to the quality of the band and perhaps their other material. But this album is really, really strong because I feel repetitive when I come away listening to an XTC song and I'm like, that was perfect. That was great. You know, because that's the same feeling I get listening to this one. First of all, I love the lyrics. He is just stuck in inactivity, in procrastination. He's stuck in a state of stagnation. The title of the song, One of the Millions, he is one of the millions, he says, of people that want to do something, say they'll do something, and then end up not doing it. They're just stuck. And that's a hard thing to get out of. Procrastination works for some people, sometimes it doesn't. I'm a good procrastinator. Sometimes, not all the times, but I think this is more of a deeper issue, just like saying you're going to do something and then never even trying to do it. You know, it's different. There's a difference between trying something and failing at it. At least you tried. But he's talking about people that haven't even left the couch or the chair to do it. Love the bass playing. Absolutely fantastic. The opening of the track, if it went in a slightly more medieval direction, it could have easily been a track by Jethro Tull. If Ian Anderson was singing on here, it wouldn't sound out of place. I think that was really cool. Perhaps that was by the percussion elements of it. The keyboards in here added a nice vibrancy and a catchy kind of bounce to the overall sheen of the track as well. The band just seemed to be doing the art pop thing right. That's what I come away listening to this. They just seem to be doing this completely right, making it their own, taking narrative, little bits of eccentricities in the music, and using it to fill in the gaps, fill in the cracks of pop music. There's that, I think it's a Japanese art style in pottery, in which if there's, I don't know the exact details of it, but basically if there's like a broken piece of pottery or with cracks in it, they fill in the cracks with gold. And I think that is one of the most beautiful like types of art, just like in sheer concept. You know, the imperfections of a sculpture, of a bowl, of a cup, of ceramic, and filling it in with gold, showing that there's like worth in the cracks, in the imperfections. And I think that XTC are, in a sense, filling in the cracked genre of pop with their own art gold. I don't know how I even got on that topic, but let's look up what that's actually called. Okay, it's called Kintsugi, or Kintsukuroi. It's the Japanese art of repairing broken pottery with lacquer, dusted, or mixed with powder, gold, silver, platinum. And the bass is very exciting to me. I mean, it is in general, but here in this track as well. Oh, singing is top-notch, by the way. I really like the way the bass picks up in just the last like few lines of the song. It goes da-da-da-da-da-da. It just does some rapid fingering really there. And I just think that sounds really cool, the way he picks it up. Just like a spark at the end, right? Just a little bit of free real estate for him to build a small little cottage. This is just a really feel-good track. I don't know. I guess you either like it or you don't. I don't feel like you could be in the mid on this one. I guess you could. You can be anywhere. Let's talk about the lyrics, though. We kind of talked about the overall concept, but I got so much to say, but I'm afraid it'll come out wrong. I'm not a king to the 80s thing, where you look after number one. So he's even scared to voice his own opinion. But I won't rock the boat because I'm scared what might happen. I won't rock the boat because I'm one of the millions who never seem to do anything. I never seem to do anything. Every time I get the urge to strike out on my own, insecurity wraps me up. It's cold outside the fold. He's safe and warm within the fold of, for lack of a better word, the other sheep, the other people who are just staying together, staying close, not wandering outside the pack, not trying to blaze or forge a trail of his own or voice his own opinion. He doesn't want to shake the boat, or rock the boat rather, because he's scared of what might happen. He's afraid of change. And he's afraid that his opinion, his thoughts, could usher in that change, whatever it might be. When, in a sense, you should voice your opinion. You know, you shouldn't be afraid of change. You shouldn't be afraid to be the voice of change. Hopefully it's a good change, of course. But That's how progress is stopped. So his stagnation is really to his detriment, because if he's not doing anything, then and he says he could drown. I would think of someone swimming in the ocean, and if you're not actively trying to float or, you know, swim, you're just going to sink. I've had my fill of living in my cozy armchair land, but all my schemes come to a humiliating end. So I won't rock the boat, I won't rock the boat. So perhaps he has tried. He says all of his schemes come to a humiliating end. So perhaps he has actually attempted to do something, to voice his opinion, to change something. And because of the fear of failure, he doesn't try anymore. I would like to know your thoughts on the track. You can leave those thoughts in the comments. Follow me on Twitter and all of that fun stuff. I hope that you're having a beautiful day. And I will talk to you tomorrow. By the way, I'm going to mention it one more time. And I'll probably mention it again at some point during this album. That is just an awesome album cover. I cannot get over it. It is just the coolest thing. It is so vibrant, colorful. Love it. I'll talk to you tomorrow, guys. Bye.